Hey everybody, I'm Eric from Valve. Today we're going to talk about a tool in Steamworks you can use to create bundles across multiple developers or publishers. Let's get right into it and I'll show you how to use the tool. All right, let's start with the most basic question, which is, what is a Steam bundle? Steam bundles are a purchase option you'll find on the Steam store that allow purchase of a group of games together, a bundle, at a discount. For players that may already own one or more of the games in that bundle, it will let that player purchase the remaining items in that bundle at that specific discount. Okay, then, what is a collaborative bundle? Collaborative bundles is a Steamworks feature that allows you to create Steam bundles that contain games from multiple developers and publishers. As a developer or publisher, if you want to create a bundle of your own games, you can do that at any time, but if you want to create a bundle that contains games from multiple developers or publishers, you want to use the collaborative bundle feature. With this feature, a developer or publisher on Steam can invite other creators to add their games to a bundle, with Steam helping to facilitate the approval process by each included game. Once everyone confirms the details, the bundle is ready for release. So the next question is, when would I want to make a collaborative bundle? Well, if you want to set up a bundle with other developers of similar games so that you can offer players a collection of similar themed games for a discounted price, then a collaborative bundle would be a great option for you. Also, sometimes developers will set up their soundtrack on Steam to be paid out directly to the musician that created that soundtrack. In this case, the musician is set up as a separate developer within Steamworks, and they have their own bank and tax information entered. And so creating a bundle of the game plus the soundtrack has been difficult in the past, but now it's possible just to create a collaborative bundle. All right, let's jump right in, and I'll show you how to set up one of these bundles. Okay, here I am on the Steamworks dashboard, and the very first thing that we want to do is create the bundle itself. So I'm going to navigate up to Apps and Packages, and select Bundles, and then scroll over to Create New Bundle. And this will give me a prompt asking me some questions about my bundle. First thing is bundle name. I'm gonna call this Really Cool Games, and we're gonna enter a bundle discount of 15%. And then it's gonna ask me, what kind of bundle do you want this to be? And there are two options. First is complete the set. In a complete the set bundle, customers can buy this bundle and they'll just pay for and receive just the products that they don't already own in their account. So for example, if in this bundle we have game A, game B, and game C, and as a customer, I already own game A, I can still buy this bundle and get the discount being offered for game B and game C by buying this bundle. The other option is must purchase together. And in a must purchase together bundle, you can only buy this bundle if you don't already own anything in the bundle. Now, in this case, I want to have a complete the set bundle, so I'm going to select that and hit create new bundle. All right, and our bundle is now created. So the next step that we need to do is to add a game to our bundle to start this off. To do that, just click the green button right here in the center called Add Packages. And as a quick reminder, you can only add a game to your bundle that is in your developer or publisher partner group. Now, I'm going to select a game that is, which is a game called Half-Life 1. And selecting that, I'm going to click the box, scroll down, hit continue. And next, you can see that Half-Life 1 has now been added to our Really Cool Games bundle. Now, this video is about the collaborative bundle feature. So to enable that, just scroll down and look over to this area called Collaborative Bundle. And if you click on Enable Collaboration, a prompt will come up asking you, are you sure you want to make this bundle collaborative? This action cannot be undone. Of course, we do. So I'm going to click on Enable Collaboration. And now that we've done that, you can see that this page looks a little bit different than it did before. There is now a progress bar indicating our process during this collaborative bundle creation. And the next step, step one, is that we need to invite participants that we want to have including games into our Really Cool Games bundle using this link. So I'm going to click on copy link, and I'm going to go ahead and email that to the partner that I was hoping would include their game in my bundle. Of course, that partner is myself because I'm testing this and showing you how to do it. So the next step is I'm going to take this link and I'm going to click on it and we're going to add another game to this bundle.
Okay, here I am on my alter ego, Eric P2, and I have clicked on the link that we generated just previously, and it's taken me to this bundle page, except that this time I am logged in as a separate user in a different partner group. And you can see that this collaborative bundle, the current state is open for edits, and it says, use the bundle below to add your game's packages to this bundle. So I am going to, because I'm interested in this bundle, I want to add one of my games to this bundle. I'm going to click on Add Packages. And here I'm going to type in a game that is in my partner group, which is Ricochet. Click on that and add Continue. And now if we scroll down, you can see that the pending packages here are Ricochet, and the packages that are already included are Half-Life 1. So now we're going to go back to the originator or owner of this bundle and take a look at the bundle from their side. All right, we are back on the account that created this bundle in the first place, and looking at the screen, you can immediately see that it looks a little different than it did when we left. And that's because if scrolling down here, you can see that the pending packages include Ricochet. And that's because on the other account, we offered to include Ricochet in this collaborative bundle. And you can see that step two is indicating that we need to lock the bundle. And that means that when you lock this bundle, you are ready to prevent further additions and edits by other developers. Once locked, all current bundle participants will need to approve any pending changes before the changes can be published. And because I wanted this collaborative bundle to only include two games, Half-Life 1 and Ricochet, I'm going to go ahead and lock this bundle. It's going to bring up a prompt. Are you sure you want to lock this bundle? Locking this bundle will prevent further additions by collaborators. And once it's locked, of course, each collaborator will need to visit the bundle page and indicate their approval of the bundle contents. So I'm going to select Lock Bundle. All right, and now you can see that the bundle is currently locked pending approvals. And before we can go ahead and release this bundle, we're going to need to hop over to our other account to approve those changes and get everything ready to go. Okay, we've hopped over to our other account, and this is the account that was invited to participate in this collaborative bundle. You can see that the current state is locked pending approvals. No other changes can be made. The only thing left that we have to do is approve those changes. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Approve Change. It's going to ask me, are you sure you want to approve these bundle changes? I'm cool with it, so this cannot be undone. Approve Change, and now the bundle is really pretty much ready to go. You can see that there's a check mark under participants. Everyone approves the change. And now we just need to go back to the originator of the collaborative bundle and we can get this thing released. Okay, we're back on the account that created this collaborative bundle. And you can see that the only thing that we need to do remaining here is to finalize the changes. Current state ready for release. I'm going to click on Finalize Change. It's going to ask me a question. Finalizing this bundle will apply the pending changes to the active bundle. If the bundle is already visible, then these changes will be applied immediately and visible to customers. So I'm going to finalize the change. And now this collaborative bundle is current state locked from edits, and we're ready to go. We can release this bundle whenever we're ready. And to do that, you would just click on Set Live. This will allow purchases of the bundle. Once set, you will no longer be able to modify the contents of this bundle. Are you sure? And if you hit OK, the bundle is then live. Okay, that's all there is to creating a collaborative bundle in Steamworks, but let's quickly recap. When should I use collaborative bundles? When you want to create a Steam bundle that contains games from multiple developers and publishers. How do I do it? Go to your Steamworks dashboard. Navigate to Apps and Packages, then scroll down to Bundles. Create a bundle with at least one of your own games in it, and then enable collaborative mode. Send a link to the developers or publishers that you want to collaborate with. Once all of the developers or publishers have added their games to the bundle can be locked from further editing. All participants then need to confirm the details of the bundle and any future changes to the bundle. This includes the games included, the bundle name, type, and discount. Once everyone has confirmed the details, the bundle owner can release the bundle. If you're looking for more information, here is a link to our documentation. And if you have any questions at all, you can contact our biz and tech teams directly using the link below.
All right, that's all you need to know about creating bundles across multiple publishers or developers. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you in the next video.